I am Marcus Gavin with Soliton Technologies, and I'm here today to talk about Peakymon. Peakymon is a Windows application used to monitor, log, and report utilization data for your test and measurement hardware. Peakymon can monitor GPIB, USB, and Ethernet traffic from your instrumentation. Peakymon runs on the PC boot in the background without impacting measurement or other applications running on your PC. Peakymon also runs without any specialized hardware.
This block diagram shows how Peakymon integrates into a typical lab setup. In this case, we have two test benches networked to a central database. Each bench has a computer connected to and controlling test instruments. Each computer runs the local Peakymon client, which monitors traffic to and from the instruments and uploads this data to the central database. A web interface allows users to view utilization reports, configure settings such as logging frequency, and update instrument data. We can access the web interface by securely logging in from a typical browser. By default, we start with a summary report of our instrument utilization data. We can view the data in a graphical or tabular manner by model, owner, or lab. We can also sort by the category selected or by the utilization percentage. Once we have the data sorted, we can download the summary report as a PNG file. To visualize instrument-specific data, we can switch to the detailed report, where we can also filter and sort by various parameters. For example, let's see what the utilization is for the E3631. Selecting a particular instrument allows us to view the utilization data over the specified time frame. Going back to the unfiltered list, we'll see that there are also setups, which are groups of instruments connected to the same PC. These are designated by the setup icon. When we select a setup, we can view the combined utilization data, as well as a list of the instruments included in the setup. The inventory page contains all the instruments and setups configured for monitoring. We can sort the data by any of the column headers, or use the search bar for more specific queries. Once we find the instrument we're looking for, we can edit the data as needed. We can also add new instruments and setups. If we have existing instrument data from another asset management system, we can import that data using the upload option. We can also export data as CSV files.
Let's take a look at our instrument setup we have today. We've got a power supply connected over GPIB using an NI USB to GPIB dongle. We also have a Tektronix scope that's communicating over USB and Ethernet. Now, to show that we're actually connected, I can go and change the range on the scope. As you can see, it's changing. Now we have some traffic we've logged, and let's look at the results.
Opening the local Peakymon client on the PC, we see that each of the instrument connections is configured for logging. We have the Ethernet connection to the oscilloscope, the USB connection to the oscilloscope, and the GPIB connection to the power supply. Note that Peakymon can auto-detect instruments on the GPIB bus. We can log additional traffic manually or from automated test routines in any language that will communicate with the instrument over the bus being monitored. For example, we can open a VESA interactive control session to the oscilloscope and query it. Returning to the web interface, we can see utilization logs from the traffic we generated by altering the scale on the oscilloscope and by executing the VESA queries. We can also see traffic from earlier this week. The configuration page allows us to specify settings such as automatic email notifications when utilization exceeds a specified threshold.
As an example of the ROI from Peakymon, a company that uses audio measurement equipment could expect a break-even point from the Pikimon purchase in 6 months to a year. Thank you for listening to this video about Pikimon. For more information, please contact us at sales@solitontech.com.